first, he said.
And why was it important for you to stick up for him?
Because he's always been a friend to me. That's what you do for friends, you tell the truth.
Then he said...
Mike was such a huge part of my career and life. We were friends for 20 years before he passed, since I was 7.
But then after he was rejected from directing the Michael Jackson Cirque du Soleil show, he conveniently changed his mind.
There was no night that went by that I was with him that he didn't sexually abuse me.
He is changing his story.
This spring, featuring the self-confessed master of deception, Wade Robson, whose own mother said his lies are so convincing that he deserves an Oscar. Should he be nominated for Best Actor? Despite testifying under oath that Michael never did anything remotely untoward, Robson suffered a breakdown due to the pressures of work and suddenly started remembering he was in fact sexually abused.
I started with one of my strongest witnesses for Michael Jackson, Wade Robson. He was adamant that he had never been touched, never been molested, never been abused, directly or indirectly. I called his mother and sister as witnesses to corroborate what he said, because they traveled on these tours too. And to have him suddenly reverse course so radically, years after Michael Jackson has passed away and can't speak up for himself, is outrageous.
Also, featuring Robson's sidekick, James Safechuck, who suddenly came to the same realization after seeing Wade file his mega money lawsuit against the MJ estate.
Safechuck I put in the same category. He didn't testify in the criminal trial, but I recall he signed declarations, made statements, that he had never been touched.
Directed by Dan Reed, who happily admits he did no investigative work or research at all, and refused to even contact anyone in order to present a balanced piece. Well done, Dan. Based on made-up events. Not featuring... the 10-year FBI investigation that found no evidence of any wrongdoing. The fact that Robson and Safechuck have had 4 different lawsuits against the MJ estate dismissed, and in fact, they owe the estate over $70,000. Not one single shred of evidence to back up any single claim made. Just a string of inconsistencies. The fact that Robson tried to shop a book deal about being abused before filing his lawsuit. At the end of the film, Robson is seen burning his MJ memorabilia for the sake of dramatic effect. But there is evidence confirmed by Julian's auction to suggest that Robson had in fact sold the genuine items to an auction company.
Robson swore under penalty of perjury that he wasn't abused. Safechuck swore under penalty of perjury that he wasn't abused.
Facts don't lie, people. Hell exposed.
He's the biggest target on the planet. He was the most famous person on the planet. He was immensely wealthy. He was perceived as immensely vulnerable. This made him a target throughout his life. And he's being attacked even in death.
The truth.